Steve said, it's really a great testimony how many people have made the trip here. So I just want to say a few words about Tom. I'm one of the older people in the audience in terms of our interactions with Tom, dating back to Minnesota in the late 70s and the early 80s. I want to tell just a couple little things about Tom from the overlap I had with him there. So one thing that came up in the conference today is this suggestion that Tom's kind of a little bit of a nerdy person in terms of, you know, liking equations and symplectic matrices and MATLAB and all that kind of nerdy stuff. But in his daily life, he's actually doesn't quite live that nerdy life. And the reason I say that is one of the nerdiest things always is to worry about second order conditions. But at one point in his career, Tom had reached this point where he was in great demand, of course, but he had managed to get these joint positions, Chicago and Hoover. Well, that's almost a dream combination for many people because you can split your time and get the best of both worlds there. But what did Tom do with this wonderful opportunity, this combination? Spent the winters in Chicago and the rest of the time in Hoover. He just never checked the second order conditions. So he talks nerdy, but he's really not so nerdy in everyday life when it comes to making his decisions. The other thing I just wanted to, as is true, I think, for all of us here, I mean, Tom is a true inspiration. And he just has an amazing ability to inspire people through lots of different ways. And I think one of the ways he would inspire students is he would, in some ways, elevate everybody to want to work on more important things and make bigger contributions. But he also had this ability, I think, to kind of connect with students in terms of the things they were going with. And in particular, as everybody here knows, as a student, there's some days things aren't going so well, you're not able to get the results, things don't seem very interesting, and you can go talk to your advisor and maybe look for some sympathy, and sometimes that's not so forthcoming, but Tom was really good at kind of getting down there with you and sharing some stories. And one story I remember, which involves Neil Walsh, I know Neil is here, there's lots of good Tom and Neil stories, but one day, kind of commiserating about this, and Tom was kind of, well, you think that's bad, let me tell you something that happened to me. And he talked about a paper that he and Neil had been working on for some time, and Tom had spent the weekend really getting into the paper, thought he had it all finished up, and then he was excited to go into the office on Monday morning, go talk to Neil, and he was so excited, saying, I'm going to show this to Neil, we're going to talk about it, and then we're going to talk, where are we going to send this, to Econometrica, to JPE, and then this is so exciting. So he goes in to meet with Neil, and he tells the story that he says, Neil, where do you think we should send it? And Neil says to him, Tom, I don't think I want my name on this paper. That's a little bit about Neil, a little bit about Tom. There's actually another Neil-Tom story, which is that, as all of you also probably know, Tom never stopped being a student. He was always going to classes, always wanting to learn more. And in Minnesota, he used to routinely go to the PhD classes. And the story has it that once he showed up in Neil Wallace's monetary theory class, sat down in the front row next to a student, and one of the students says to him, are you here for Neil's monetary class? And Tom says, no, I was just looking for a quiet place to read. So on a little bit of a more serious note, I'll just say all of us have been inspired by Tom. I know that's absolutely true for me. When I first showed up at graduate school in Minnesota, I think I saw myself going on a math econ, they now call it theory track, but I had Tom as a professor in first year for macro, and just being in his presence and hearing him talk about the stuff that he was working on just got me so excited that it certainly changed what I wanted to do. And I think that's true for many of us here. And for those of us who were at Minnesota back in those times, we always talked about Minnesota being a very special place. place, and I think that was true. When people talk about something about the nature of Minnesota, like this is something about Minnesota that was special at that time, and I think when you look over time, you see something kind of interesting, that Minnesota was a very special place in terms of the graduate program. Then Tom went to Chicago, and all of a sudden Chicago was kind of a very special place to be a graduate student. Then he moved to Stanford, and all of a sudden Stanford was a very special place to be a graduate student. And now he moved to NYU, and all of a sudden NYU is a very special place to be a graduate student. And so while it was true that Minnesota was a very special place, I think the most revealing or the strongest thing which is true is that Tom is a very special person, and I think we're here tonight to celebrate Tom's specialness. And so I just want to raise a glass to toast Tom, a very special person who's had amazing influence on everybody here, and we're very grateful.